I'm going to show you how to change a sky in a photo in just 5 easy steps. Hey, I'm Tim from timsphotos.com. I'm a landscape photographer and I've got a question for you. What's the difference between studio photographers and landscape photographers? Well, studio photographers bring their lights with them and they control the lighting. But landscape photographers have to rely upon whatever the lighting is on that particular day, which means that we can't stay out in the field in the mountains for 365 consecutive days waiting for the perfect sky. And that means every now and then we need to change the sky in Photoshop. And I'm going to show you how to do that in 5 quick, easy steps. So I've got this open in Photoshop, and this is a panorama. I think it's about 6 images stitched into one. So it's a very large image, something like 12,000 pixels wide. And I love the image, but I hate the sky. It's the most blah sky, and I don't like it. So let's change this sky. We're going to do this in 5 steps. Here's step 1 of 5. Choose the layer that is going to be on top, the layer that we're going to keep, and let's use the select and mask command. Up in the top right, I want to go to marching ants. Select the very top brush in the top left, which is called the quick selection tool. And I am going to select the area that I want to keep. And I'm left clicking and holding down. And I'm still holding. And remember, this is the area I want to keep. And I'm going to make sure that I select the whole thing. So this is now our rough selection. Step 2 out of 5 is to refine the mask. I'm going to click the Refine Edge Brush tool. And I'm going to zoom in to 100%. Now let's pan across. And I do this by holding down the space bar and dragging with the little hand. I'm still holding the space bar. Okay, letting go. I'm going to increase the size of my brush by hitting the right bracket. Left click along that edge and let go, and then let Photoshop do its work. Let's do it again. Let go. Let Photoshop calculate. Going to scroll, hold down the space bar. Once again, left click and drag along this edge. I'm going to go right to the edge of the building and then let Photoshop calculate. Here, I've let go now. And it's looking pretty good. You can see that it's accommodated for these holes up here, which is perfect. Going to refine this edge. Let's see how Photoshop does on this. Looking good along this edge. Now, in this case, I didn't like that. So I'm going to hit Control Z, Control Z. And that'll save me a little bit of work later. Now, continuing with refining the edge, there are a couple of things up in here that need to be tweaked. Also, this sky is not showing through. This is looking good, but I've got some areas right here that need to be eliminated. So I click the third brush down, and I just have to brush over those areas that I absolutely know I want to keep. Little mistake there, Control Z. And redo this. This is looking fantastic. A couple other little holes in the roof line that Photoshop put there, thinking that it was so bright that it was a sky. Just eliminating those with the brush tool. Now I'm going to zoom in to 200% and try and fix these holes. Now in the top right, click the view drop down
go to overlay, and it's going to show everything in red that is going to be revealed. And I'm going to zoom in to 100% and take a look for things that are red. Here, this is a bit of a problem. So let's take that brush, make the brush bigger by hitting the right bracket and brush over that. Now we need to make adjustments on the global refinement sliders. I'm not going to touch the smooth, but I am going to move the feather to 1 pixel. And I'm going to pay close attention to the edges of these branches here, because I want them to have somewhat of a sharp edge. Zoom into 200%. Take a good look at these edges, because as it is now, you can see that the red is infiltrating into the bushes and the trees. And that means that once we render this thing out, it's going to have a white color tone to the edges that have a bit of red in them. So let's enhance the contrast up to 20% and see if it makes a difference. I always just make the adjustment and then wait and see the difference. And already that red has disappeared for the most part out of the edges. I can still see some here. Let's bump the contrast up to 30% and then wait, watch. And there's our improvement. I'm going to enhance the feather up to 4 pixels and just see what it does. Make the adjustment, wait, let your computer process. And I don't like it. It introduced a bunch of white. So I'll pull that back down to 1 pixel where it was in the first place. And there's the adjustment. I'm going to call this done. Click OK, fit on screen. We're ready for step 3, which is to bring in the new background layer. Open up the file for the new background layer. This is a raw image, so it's going to open up the raw editor. I'm fairly happy with the way that it looks now, but I'm going to drop the highlights a bit and open up the shadows. I'm not trying for any sort of a wild look. I could easily crank up the vibrance on this, and it's an amazing looking sky, but I don't think that it's going to be consistent with the setting that I have here on the ground, because we just don't have those color tones that are reflected on the ground. Step 4 of 5 is to import the new sky into our existing image. Click Select All, Edit, Copy. Open the original tab where our work is, Edit, Paste. Now we need to resize the image. Control T for the transform command. Click this little link button at the top so that the aspect ratio won't change when I drag the corners. Pull the right side to the edge. Pull the left side to the left edge. Hit enter to accept the transformation. Pull the new layer down to the bottom. Click the move tool and move the new sky to any height that I want it to be. This doesn't look real to me. This does. Step 5, the last and final step, is to adjust any color imbalances. This particular image was quite problematic because I took the photo when there was still some sun hitting the ground. This entire left side of the mountain had sun on it. The right side was in the shade, and there was also sun hitting across the tops of the lavender here. So I spent a considerable amount of time using the burn tool set at 9% exposure and making adjustments to midtones as well as highlights. and I darkened this left side of the mountain. I also darkened the tops of the lavender where the sun was hitting it. And the reason for this is because it didn't look right. It was obvious that there was sun shining from camera right over onto the left side of the frame, and it didn't match up with what I was seeing in the clouds. So I made it appear as if the image was shot during a sunset time, and this would be consistent with the type of sunset look that's occurring up there in the clouds. So that's it in five steps. I'm happy with the image now. It's, as I said, it's 12,000 pixels wide, so this could be printed very large. Let's take a look at the edge at 100% and just see how the cropping looks. This looks flawless. This is perfect. Very good. Very nice looking up along the top. No problems there at all. So let's look at the before. And here's the after. And we just transformed this image to something that I think looks very nice.
And that is how you change a sky in five easy steps. And in case you were wondering, the image that I used for this tutorial is from the south of France in Provence at the Senanque Abbey, which was founded in the year 1148. It's an amazing place. So if you liked this video, if you found value in it, I'm going to ask you to do a really easy thing, and that is click on the red subscribe button. It's kind of like following someone on Instagram, and it means that you'll be notified of any future videos that I upload, and I'm trying to do two per week. So thanks so much. See you in the next video, and please do give it a thumbs up, leave a comment. It helps me out a lot. Thanks.